It's Shannon back with another scrapbook processing video, and this is part of the monthly sketch challenge at Let's Get Sketchy. And here is the February sketch, and so I'm going to get started on what my interpretation of that was. And so I am keeping to working on my most recent Walt Disney trip that I went to back in November. And as you can see, there's my mask. And this was kind of a funny picture because at Disney Springs, there's a Coca-Cola store, if you've not been there. And the Coca-Cola polar bear is usually there for photo ops. And it was, but you had to stand a lot farther away and take a picture. And apparently I was not very good at it because, as you can see the polar bear really well, but my husband and I got cut off quite a bit. But I thought it was a fun picture, and so I still wanted to scrap it. And so I am continuing on with my spending freeze. And so I am dedicated to using up some of my scraps. And I recently just reorganized them and put them in by color and theme. And so it made it really easy to find some red and white papers and maybe just a little bit of black and white too. I think there's some Prima there. I believe that's Bo Bunny. I think there's some Bella Boulevard that I end up not using, some Pink Fresh Studio. So there's just sort of a scattering of a lot of different kinds. And so I really wanted to layer up these papers, and so I'm just cutting apart a bunch of them. I think that's Imagine-S right there. Some of these companies obviously are no longer around, and I miss them very much. And so I was glad to have a few of their scraps left. So I'm just really cutting these and trying to get various shapes and strips, and then I want to just layer them up. I had already backed my photo with some black to allow it to pop off the page, and that paper there is an old Scrap and Sports and More, if you remember them. I really enjoyed, they were mostly obviously sports themed, and I believe this is from the baseball collection. So I'm just trying to get it a little bit centered. I don't usually measure too much, but I did want to make sure that it was centered and somewhat straight. So I'll just continue to layer up the papers. I wanted to make sure that you could see the black and the red and the different variations in the colors in the paper. And some of them I didn't have enough, and so I wanted to cut them so that you could not see the missing pieces behind the photo. So I did that with this one. I believe this is an old Prima paper, and so I wanted to make sure that you could see it at the top and the bottom. And there I am with another black and white, just to add a little bit of just add a little variation in color. And I noticed, I think this one is the one I didn't get quite straight, and so I'm going to go back and straighten it later, I believe. And so there's just another little red and white. I wanted to also vary the patterns. I think I have some polka dots and some stripes and some zigzags and some diagonals. Just a lot of different colors and textures. And then this is a postcard that I got while we were at the Coca-Cola store. And I thought it would really go with this picture. Since the picture is really pretty bad, I did at least want to bring in kind of a fun little postcard that went with it. So there's some polka dots. Wanted to just kind of put a little bit more on there, just to bring out the photo mat just a little bit. And bring that black and white back in. So the photo mat is going to get kind of thick, but I think it all works out at the end. And it's not too thick that I would have to pop up that polar bear, but it did end up working. So I'm trying to cut this, but It did not work. I'm gonna have to go back in and cut it because it didn't end up straight. So I will, you'll see me there trying to straighten it up a little bit. So it really was kind of a fun and, I don't know, surreal feeling to be back at Disney Springs. It was not nearly as busy as it has been in past years, but it was still kind of busy. And so we did try to stay 6 feet away and adhere to all of that. And really tried to document in some ways some of the differences before the pandemic and now during the pandemic, some of those differences. And this selfie is definitely something that highlights that. So I kind of like that I'm going to be adding that into my scrapbook because it really does tell the story. And you'll see it a little bit with my journaling. Here's where I'm trying to straighten that red polka dot. I noticed that it just looked really wonky, and so I wanted to make sure that I got that straight. It's a good thing that I kind of use repositionable adhesive because I have a tendency to do that a lot. Getting things straight apparently is not my thing. So just adding a little bit more, and then these little tickets. I believe they are from Simple Stories or Echo Park. I don't have it right here in front of me, but the whole paper is just tickets. And so I wanted to cut out just a couple of more because they are red and black. And I wanted to add a few because I didn't really have a lot of embellishments for this. So I wanted to kind of make my own. I do have a sticker that is a Coca-Cola sticker, and I believe I got that from Wish, believe it or not, a long time ago. And I had already done a Coca-Cola layout for something else, and I think that was the one little sticker that I had left that I hadn't used. And so I'm kind of moving that around, trying to find a good place for it. And then I decided I was going to put this last little sticker down here. So I sort of had this red black pattern going on. So it seems to kind of provide a good mat for that really bright Coca-Cola sticker up there. And then I'm going to be working on my title. I really had a tough time. I don't know about you guys, but I have a really hard time coming up with witty titles. Sometimes I rely on my family, who are way better at titles than I am. But I have these really cute thickers from American Craft, and I really like the fonts. You can actually use a more printed font or a more cursive font, or you can mix them. And I knew I wanted to kind of play off the word bear. And so my title is going to be Barely Got It, which, if you read the journaling afterwards, it will talk about how I barely got us actually in the picture. And you don't really have a lot of time to stand and take a lot of selfies because there is a line. And so I think I was just kind of trying to get in and get out and also kind of appease my husband because I'm sure that he was very tired of me taking photos at that point. But hey, scrapper's got to do what a scrapper's got to do, right? So I'm just kind of arranging the letters and making sure that I get the font that I want from this since there is a mixed font. And I really like that they put these on clear backing now because you can really get an idea of where you're placing your letters. And despite that, I was going to put the barely on top of got it, and I realized that between the Y and barely and the T's, it just didn't really work. And so I'm going to be moving around my title a couple of times. And so I apologize for that, but I know you guys get it. You put it on there and then it moves around and it moves around. But I did finally get it moved over. I think at one point I got it. See, there's where I'm trying to get them to stack and it just didn't work. And so, see, I'm even still trying. I'm just working and working to try and get that barely to go there because I really wanted to keep with that horizontal. with my embellishments and my title, but I don't think it looks bad all on one line. I think it was short enough that it basically spanned the pattern paper, and so I think it'll probably work out okay. I was happy with it, so I guess that's all that matters, right? So and the dot for the eye kept getting stuck on my finger, so there was that. So I'm just kind of moving it over, and I think I did actually get I had to move it over again because it wasn't quite over far enough, and so it probably would have been a good idea at that point for me to actually take the word barely that was on the clear backing that I was talking so highly about and sit it down to see how far it was going to go. But I think it was kind of late when I shot this video, and yeah, I just wasn't thinking too clearly about that kind of thing. So you're going to see me put it down, and then I'm going to pull it back up. So yeah, I'm like, yeah, it needs to go over a little bit more. I feel like that happens a lot with titles. We get it just right, and then it just has to go a little bit more. Because if you'll look under that B, I really didn't like all that empty space. I didn't want to put another embellishment cluster there, and I didn't want to leave all that empty space there. I suppose I could have put another embellishment cluster under the B if I didn't want to move all of the letters, but this seemed to work. And honestly, I didn't have a lot of embellishments that I wanted to put on this because I felt like the layers of paper were pretty busy, and the postcard was actually a large part of the layout, and so I really wanted that to just be the focus and be good with a lot of this white space. So there we go. I barely got that title on there too, so I guess that is appropriate. So there is basic layout. I'm going to put some splatters on there. After I put that away, I'm covering that up, and because I didn't want to get the splatters on my picture. And I think this is Tattered Angel. It's just kind of a black, it's kind of a chalky black. So I'm just kind of splattering it around, trying to get some good coverage there. I don't splatter a whole lot, and so I didn't really. It's not really in my comfort zone. It's not my favorite thing to do. And so I did want to get a few bigger dots. And at one point, I think I put some dots on there that were just a little bit too big. And luckily, I was able to kind of soak those up with a paper towel, and it all worked out. But at this point, I'm just kind of looking around to see what I want it to look like. And of course, it's a Disney layout, and so I'm going to take my Mickey head punch, and this is from EK Success, and just kind of hide it in there. So, all of my layouts, if you follow me, all of my layouts have all of my Disney layouts anyway, always have at least one hidden Mickey, and so I had to put that on there as well. That's pretty much going to be the layout. I am going to put my journaling in afterwards. And so here are some of the close-ups. And yeah, there's that postcard. So thanks again for watching, and please take time to like and follow, and I will see you later.